and welcome to this painting video. And in this video, we'll be showing you how to paint the Cadian Command flag and apply a transfer. But first, we need to undercoat our model, and as you can see, we've used Wraithbone for this. And first, we're going to be applying some base coat, and we'll be using Mephiston Red for the red details, Corvus Black for the black details, and Corax White for the Cadian emblem. So, we're going to dip into our pot here of Mephiston Red. We're going to thin it down. We're going to get our brush to a point, and then we can start applying it to the flag. As you can see here, we've got a flag emblem here, and what we're going to do is we're going to paint into these four sections here. So we're going to paint into the top, the bottom, and the left and the right. And just try and be neat around the edging because we want to keep that cream. Next, we're going to use our Corvus Black, and we're going to use this in the other sections and the center section as well on the flag. And just like before, avoiding the cream edging and iconography. Finally, we're going to use our Corax White, and we're going to put that all over the Cadian emblem. So it's the wings and the little flame and the crown and the lightning bolts. And you just may need a couple of layers of the white. With our base coats now done, we can move on to our contrasts and shades. For these, we'll be using Skeleton Horde Thin Down Contrast Medium, Nazdrake Yellow, Soul Blight Grey, and Null Noil. So we're going to dip into our pot of Contrast Medium first. So we need one part, and then we need a second part. Pop that on. I'm going to wash my brush and dry it off quickly. And then I'm going to take one part Skeleton Horde. What we're going to do is just thin it down slightly. I'm going to make sure we don't have too much on our brush. Yeah, brush to a slight point, and then we can start applying it to the cream detail area. So for this, we're just going to put it all over, but we're going to be focusing on those like ruched up areas on the flag. It does start to pool, don't worry, clean off your brush and soak it up. Next, we're going to use Nazdrake Yellow straight from the pot. And for this, we're going to use it on the emblem, but we're not going to paint the white wings yet. Just make sure you don't have too much of the paint on the brush. You can always add a little bit more afterwards, just to avoid pooling. Now we're going to use the Soul Blight Grey on those wings. So just like before, we're going to add a little bit, but not too much, so it doesn't start pooling all over the place. You most definitely want to get some in those creases on the side of the flag. Next, we're going to move on to our non-oil, and for this we're going to pop it on the red and the black areas. We're going to pop it all in those folds and creases, but we're not going to be too heavy with it. With those contrasts and shades now dry, we can move on to some highlighting. And for these we'll be using Pallid Witch Flesh, Wazdaka Red, Thunderhawk Blue, Zamisi Desert and White Scar. So we're going to just dip into our pot here of our Pallid Witch Flesh. And pop it on the palette. I'm going to thin it down just a touch of water, and then we're going to apply it to our model. So we're going to use this paint just to outline all of the cream and also the scroll work inside on the flag. I'm going to pick out all of those edges. Next, we're going to move on to the Wazdaka Red, and for this we're just going to pick out the folded edges of the red cloth. And now we're going to take Thunderhawk Blue and do exactly the same on the black parts of the flag. Next, we're going to take our Zamisi Desert, and then we're going to use it on the edges of the Nazdrake Yellow areas. So we just want to be careful, but we just want to add a nice edge to it. And finally, we're going to use White Scar for the wings. I'm just going to do exactly the same. I'm just going to pick out the folds, which is a nice straight line, and I'm going to go around all of the edges if we can. With our flag now painted, we can move on to our transfer stage. And for this, we'll be starting off with a layer of Storm Shield, then we'll apply the transfer, then we'll put another layer of Storm Shield over the top of that, and then finish it off with Larmium Medium. So we're going to dip into our pot of Storm Shield here. We don't need too much, we're just going to pop a little bit on the end of our brush, and then we can start popping it onto the area we want painted. So I'm just going to pop it on this bottom scroll just here. I'm going to smooth it all out. And we're doing this so it gives the transfer a nice smooth adhere area to cling to. Now for our transfer, as you can see, I've cut it out the sheet of transfers already. I've put little score marks in between each letter so it's easier to apply it. If you are under the age of 18 or aren't sure about using a knife, you can always ask an adult to do it for you. Now we're going to wet our transfer, and for this we're going to take some nice clean water onto our brush, and then we're going to start soaking the transfer with the water. So you might need a couple of brushes worth. I'm just going to make sure that it's nice and soaked. And it could take up to about 5 minutes for those transfers to come off the paper. Now that our transfer is ready, we're going to take our small brush here, and we're going to slowly push underneath the letter C. And then we can pick it up, like so, and then we can start popping it onto the banner. So we're going to put it on this lower one here that we've already varnished. I'm going to gently pop it on, I'm going to push it down. And whilst it's still wet, you can manoeuvre it around a little bit, but that looks perfect to me. We've cut up the letters so they're all separate. This is a lot easier to transfer, especially when it's on a curved area. Now that we've put the rest of our letters on and we've allowed it to dry, we're going to put our second layer of Storm Shield over the top of them. It's going to be very gentle, and we're going to apply a little bit over the top. And now we're going to leave that to dry. And finally, we're going to give it a layer of Lamium Medium so we can get it to a matte finish. And there we have it, our command flag is now complete. And remember, you can always use any of these techniques on any of the models in your collection. Well, I hope you enjoyed this painting video, and we hope to see you again soon. Bye bye!